Good morning, everybody. Today I'm going to start Civics Chapter 2, Role of the Government in Health. So, in this chapter, you have to understand what is the role of the government in health. What is health? Health means our ability to remain free of illness and injuries. Next, apart from disease, there are various factors that affect our health. Next, for example, if people get clean drinking water or pollution-free environment, they are likely to be healthy. So, in this slide, you have to understand the meaning of health. The common definition of health is the ability of a person to remain free of illness and injuries. Already we have discussed here. But health is not only about disease. It is something more than that. Apart from disease, we need to think of our factors such as safe drinking water, clean surroundings, etc. because they affect our health in various ways. If people fail to get these basic amenities of life, they will fall ill. Being active and good spirits are also essential, a part of health. We also need to be without mental stress, because we cannot be healthy for a long time if we are under mental strain. So I think this will be clear, the meaning of health. Now I'm going to discuss about the healthcare in India. India has the largest number of medical colleges in the world and is among the largest producer of doctors and is among the largest producer of doctors. So most doctors settle in urban areas, while people in rural areas have to travel long distance to get medical facilities. India is the fourth largest producer of medicines in the world and also a large exporter of medicines. India gets a large number of medical tourists from many countries. About 5 lakh people die from tuberculosis, while 2 million cases of malaria are reported every year. Half of the children in India do not get adequate food to eat and are undernourished. So, healthcare facilities include health centers, hospitals, laboratories for tests, ambulance services, blood banks, etc. In order to run such facilities, we need health workers, nurses, qualified doctors, etc. And also we need medicines and equipments that are essential for treating patients. Healthcare facilities are roughly divided into two categories. First is public health services. Second is private health services. Now, you have to understand about the public health services. First, the public health services is a chain of health centers and hospitals run by the government. At the village level, there are health centers where there is usually a nurse and a village health worker. Next, at district level is the district hospitals that supervise all the health centers. The public health service is meant to provide quality healthcare service either free or at low cost, so that even poor can seek treatment. In a better way, you can understand, under public health system, equality and quality health care services are provided either free of cost or low cost, so that even can seek the treatment. Under this system, action is also taken to prevent the spread of diseases like tuberculosis, malaria, jaundice, diarrhea, chikungunya, etc. Next is private health services. In this, a large number of doctors run their own private clinics. In a village, one finds registered medical practitioners, that is called RMPs. Under areas have a large number of doctors, many of them providing specialized services. Private health facilities are not controlled or owned by the government, that is run by individually. The patient has to pay a lot of money for every service that they enjoy. Poor people find it difficult to get treatment here. Here you can understand in a better way with an example. Like story has been given in your book, Ranjan belonged to a well-to-do family. Hence, his parents took him a private hospital and got quick treatment by spending a huge amount of money. And on another side, you see, in public healthcare services, there are always a rush at the public hospitals. Hence, you have already seen, must be read book. Aman had to wait in a long queue at the OPD counter. He was feeling so sick that he had to lean on his father all the time. When their turn came, the doctor examined Aman and asked for a blood test. Then they had to go and stand in another long queue. They got the test results after 3 days. In order to avoid such situations, there should be more qualified doctors and medically trained persons. Facilities should be improved and extended. More and more branches of healthcare facilities should be provided. More and more mobile clinics should also be there. So, in these public healthcare services and private healthcare services, you must be understand healthcare and equality. This we will understand in the next video.